Inspired by the thousands of Britons who give to children overseas, the Mullins are sponsoring a family here in the UK.
Dear Brandon, we have just seen the DVD. I hope that we can help.
Brandon, I'm sorry you don't have your own bedroom. It must be uncomfortable sleeping on the sofa. Also, my family are hoping we can help you. By the way, my name is Daisy and I'm 10.
Dear Daisy, thanks for the letter. It's comfortable sleeping on the sofa.
Pretty bad.
You're heavy, aren't you?
My mum is called Michaela and my dad is called Sean and he drives the buses. He's not my real dad, but it's a bit of a long story. My first dad, I think he's in, I don't know, Brisbane, I think it is. And, well, I've had three. I don't know my real dad's name. I've had Gary and now it's Sean. Yours sincerely, Brandon.
With the sponsorship yet to start, Sean is feeling the pressure of providing for his family of four. His take-home pay, plus Michaela's benefits, a total of £413, must last the family the whole week.
Can I pay the rent? Thursday is supposed to be a good day. It's the day I get paid. Thursday, for me personally, is the worst day of the week. It really is. It's stressful, it's heartbreaking, it's just horrible.
I've got a gas and electric key in here somewhere.
Wages comes in, and within 2 hours of finishing work, I have no wages left.
Thanks a lot. Thank you. See you later.
Just this week, I've been down, I've paid the rent, I've put some money on the gas and some money on the electric. I've got £100 left, and I've still got to find the money for Brandon's shoes. It's got to come from somewhere, and the only place it can come from is not paying some of the bills, which means we get in arrears again. Next week and over the next few weeks, we'll just have to start paying a little bit extra on those bills, which just leave us short on other bills, and it's a constant juggling act.
The Mullins are about to contact the O'Dwyers and start the sponsorship.
You'd be lying if you didn't say you wasn't slightly concerned. I mean, yeah, we wanted to go to the white people. I mean, of course, don't we? I mean,
yeah,
you know,
don't want them to spend it on stupid things.
No, really. I suppose in the back of our minds at the moment, we're thinking, where is it going? Yeah, it is in the back of our minds a little bit, yeah.
We've got some letters from the other family.
Oh, oh wow. Well.
Oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God.
That, stop. This one first.
Fine.
It says...
Wow.
Dear Sean and Michaela, after finally seeing you all on the DVD, you came across as a really nice family. I'm sorry Brandon doesn't have his own bedroom, but after watching you, we thought he came over a very positive and clear young man. You must be very proud. We are looking forward to meeting you at some point. We think you'll get on extremely well with our family. And finally, here is an envelope which we hope may help in some way. All our love, Scott and Sam. Okay?
Quick, open it! That's really nice.
Yeah, it is.
Oh my God.
It's a cheque. £2,000.
Oh my God! £2,000?
Wow.
Cool.
Wow. Well, what are we going to do first?
We're going to smile and relax.
Yes.
And not worry about the bills next week. We don't have to worry. Imagine being able to just give £2,000 away. I can't quite believe it.
Sometimes you just have to swallow your pride. I'm not too proud to accept help when it's offered. I think anybody that did would be a fool. As I say, I could never thank these people enough. I really couldn't. The generosity is just amazing, it really is.
Dear Brandon, I wanted to know if you support any football team. When I grow up, I want to be a footballer. But if that don't happen, I'll probably become property developer. You earn a lot of money doing property developer if you do it up good.
I hope I get the chance to meet you right back. Yours sincerely, Ashley Mullins.
Dear Ashley, thanks for the letter. I'd like to be an inventor and invent stuff.
Hi there. Hello.
Maybe inventing special probes that can launch in space and see what it's like and maybe look for other planets. It's really amazing because you'll never know what you'll find. Like maybe a black hole or a star that's dying or burning up. Love, Brandon.
Right, we've got £2,000, top of the list, council tax.
Anti-bailiff money, 300. Washer dryer, I'd say to allow 300 for the washer.
Yeah.
Some form of storage.
Yes.
For our clothes.
Yeah.
200?
Okay, 200. Ooh. Right, we've got 350 left.
And the stereo. Oh, gosh, at all.
Yeah.
Oh. That's just about enough to get a computer.
Oh, much though I hate to.
Well, put PC question mark.
Yeah.
Because we need clothes.
I was just about to say clothes. Uniform. Yeah, exactly.
Done.
Spend.
Forget the PC.
For now, yeah. Oh, good morning. Yeah, could I pay my council tax arrears, please? All of it, please. Waha. Can I just confirm that was the arrears paid in full? Excellent. Thank you very much indeed. Bye-bye. It's great, because that was... that obviously is the one that was playing on my mind most because of the bailiff turning up and everything else. So good to get that out of the way. Chuffed to bits. And the amazing thing is, we've still got money in the bank! Oh, that's big.
Good,
that's
yeah.
Really good, yeah.
We've actually got this one on offer at the moment. It's normally £269.99, but we're actually doing it for £245. Thank you very much indeed.
Although they've paid the bills and bought a washer-dryer, Michaela is breaking with the plan to buy clothes for the kids, opting for a computer instead.